Professor Dave here. Let's learn about least common multiples.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
As we begin to learn more about numbers, there are certain ways in which we will want to compare two numbers. One concept we must learn is that of a multiple. 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 3 is 9. 3 times 4 is 12. So these are examples of multiples of 3. They are the numbers you get when you multiply 3 by all the positive integers, and the list goes on all the way to infinity. What about for the number 4? Well, that would give us 4, 8, 12, 16, and so on. And we could construct multiplication tables like these as we go through all the numbers. So what if we compare 3 and 4? We might want to know the smallest number that is in both of these lists. We would call this the least common multiple because it is the smallest multiple that is common to both numbers. In this case, that's 12. Let's list the multiples of 5 now. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. What is the least common multiple of 3 and 5? That would be 15. What about 4 and 5? That would be 20. As we can see, many times the least common multiple is simply the product of the two numbers. This product will always be a common multiple because the product of the two numbers must necessarily have the two original numbers as factors. However, this will not always be the least common multiple. Sometimes there is a smaller common multiple. Take 6 and 9. 6 times 9 is 54. But if we write out the multiples for both numbers, we find that already at 18, we get the least common multiple. So when looking at smaller numbers, it is a good idea to write out the multiples to find the answer. Once we get to some bigger numbers, this method may get tedious, so there is a bit of a shortcut. Take the numbers 12 and 80. The first step will be to find the prime factorization of each number. For 12, that's 2 times 2 times 3. And for 80, that's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 5. Now we simply take every factor we see here and multiply them together, with each factor being multiplied a number of times equal to the most times it appears for one number. 2 appears 4 times for 80, which is more than the 2 times it appears for 12. So let's put 4 twos, and then the 1 3, and then the 1 5. We find the product, and that's 240. So this will be the least common multiple for 12 and 80. What is one application of this concept? Well, we learned about fractions, and sometimes we might want to know which of two fractions is larger, which can be difficult if they have different numbers in the denominator. Take 1/3 and 1/4, for example. It's true that if we represent these fractions as sections of a circle, it is pretty easy to see that 1/3 is larger, but this becomes even more obvious if we alter these fractions so that they do have the same denominator by finding the least common multiple. For 3 and 4, that's 12. So what do we need to do to get 12 on the denominator for both of these fractions? For 1/3, we can multiply both top and bottom by 4. If we do this, we are not altering the magnitude of the fraction, because 4 over 4 is 1, and anything times 1 is itself. But we can change the way the fraction is expressed. Now we have 4/12. For 1/4, we can multiply by 3 over 3, giving us 3/12. Now that they have the same denominator, it is easy to see that 4 is bigger than 3, so 4/12 must be bigger than 3/12. Although it was already obvious in this instance, we can use this technique for much trickier fractions so that we can be sure as to which one is larger. Let's check comprehension. Thank you. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.